Okay, so please find your table and then stand there so we can get an official picture. So then if you win, we have the picture to put on the local newspaper, okay? Did any of the teachers, you can go in the auditorium to watch the live stream. We are going to close the door. Just wish good luck to your students, and then you can go watch the live stream downstairs. Yes, you can wait, like we have. Yes. Okay, can we close the doors? How did the morning tours go? Did you like them? Okay, great. I think we are almost ready to start. It seems surreal to be here. This morning I was super excited and just happy. Now I'm starting to get nervous, so I cannot imagine. You guys, I think you remember the 3D printer I mentioned this morning. It is right here, and our amazing IT specialist, Matt, already 3D printed a bee, and he tested everything. So the 3D printer is ready to go. We are going to raffle it at the end of the first round, and whoever school win the 3D printer is also going to get Matt for the training. So he's coming with a 3D printer, okay? I think we are ready to start officially. Welcome to the 2022 Brain Bee Challenge. I cannot believe I'm saying this and we are finally doing it. Fun fact, I don't know if you noticed my bee earrings. I stored them for 3 years and finally I get to wear them. So welcome again to Max Planck. We are in. We are incredibly happy to have you here in the tours this morning, and we really hope you enjoy the competition this afternoon. Before starting, I need to thank everyone that made this competition possible. First, the Mary and Robert Pugh Public Education Fund. They are the ones that are making every year the Brain Bee possible since the inception a long time ago. So thank you so much. I also want to thank your teachers, the ones that encourage you to form a team and that help you study. Thank you so much also to them. And then I want to thank and introduce the judges for today. We have Dr. Maria Alvera Carlson-Sin. Dr. Anand Jain. And Arielle Lewis Sanders. Thank you so much for volunteering your time to help in the competition. And last but not least, I want to thank all the MPFI staff. As I told you this morning, I think there are close to 35 people from Max Planck that are working on a Saturday to make this competition possible. And so thank you so much for working hard for today. Now we really start. A quick recap about the rules. You already all put your cell phone in the envelope in your table. They are going to stay there up to the end of the competition. When I finish to ask the question, there is going to be a timer with 30 seconds. In those 30 seconds, you can talk to your teammate and then write your answer in one of the cards that are on your table. Please do me a favor and double check that the cards on your table have your team name and number. When the time is up, there are going to be volunteers. Thank you, guys. Passing through the tables, please give them your answer and then they will bring them to the judges. Each answer gets 1 point and this will make more sense later. As I said, first round, 20 questions, and at the end of the first round, we are going to eliminate 10 teams. The second round has 10 questions, and only 3 teams are going to make it to the final round. The final round is direct elimination, so if you don't get the answer right, you're out. There might be questions towards the end of the competition that I'm going to name brain buzz question. For those questions, each member of the team has to write down their own, his or her own answer without talking to the members, to the other members of the team. And in that case, each correct answer counts as one. So you can get a maximum of 3 points if all the three members get it right. Do we have any question before we start? Okay, good luck and have fun. Let the first round begin. 20 questions, the best 10 teams qualify for the next round. Okay, who has a question? What is it? No more question? Oh yeah, check that your pen writes, so because when the 30 seconds starts. Are we all ready? Yes or no? Okay. First question. Mm-hmm. By the way, we are starting easy and then we are going up. Yes. Yes, exactly. Ready, pen in hand, you can talk to your teammates, but not to other teams. This is the first question. In addition to the classical 5 senses, which of the following senses have also been identified? Telepathy, clairvoyance, extrasensory perception, or ESP, all of the above. Oh, wait, I forgot. The last is the ability to spot a joke. Of course. Okay, this was the trial run. It was a joke, Tara. It is a joke. Did someone seriously thought that there is a sense of the ability to see in the future? Okay, now serious, we really start. This is the real first question. The nervous system has three parts: the brain, the spinal cord, and the answer was peripheral nerves. Each one. Okay, ready for the next question? This part of the eye around the fovea is critical for reading and driving. What's his name? Time is up. Please hand your answer cards. If you don't write anything, just don't. Okay, the answer was the macula. Next question is from one of the morning tours. What does the D instead microscopy stand for? What does the letter D instead microscopy? So is stimulated emission D for? How is it going, guys? It's hard, easy? Okay, next question. What part of the brain is important for emotional learning? Time is up. The answer was amygdala. Oh. Okay, ready for the next question? What type of memory is responsible for our factual knowledge? The answer was semantic memory. The next question is from one of the morning tours. What is the name of the cellular structure depicted in this EM cross section? Time is up. The answer was psyllium. Next question. What term describes the brain's ability to change? Time is up. The answer was plasticity. This is an easy one, I hope. Name the sensory organ found in the tongue. The answer is taste buds. So for the next question, I expect a perfect score, otherwise you didn't listen to me this morning. How many chromosomes does Drosophila meganogaster have? The answer is 4.
I do not know.
So we are midway of the first round. And I actually realize I probably put the hardest one at the beginning. I'm sorry. Next question.
Okay.
What material cannot be cut with an EDM machine, also known as the sword, the laser sword? Time is up. The only material you cannot cut with the EDM machine is plastic, because the EDM machine needs something that is let the electricity pass. Another question from the morning tours. Good. What's the name of the brain area circle in blue? The answer was cerebellum. And also for the previous question, the one about the ADM machine, both plastic and non-conductive material is correct. So both answers are correct. So I put up there the answer is on the book or as we explain it, but as long as the concept is the right one, we are going to count it as correct, okay? Ready for the next one? The arrival of an action potential at an axonal button opens channel that let which ion in? The answer is calcium. Next question. We are approaching the last, sorry? So the question I'm asking now is number 14. What's the name of these highly plastic structures inside the brain? The one with the white arrows. This was a question from the light microscopy tour, and the answer was dendritic spines. It counts, okay? He works on the topic, so we have a judge on the topic, he's going to decide. Next question. What's the name for the gaps between myelin segments on an axon? The answer was node. The next question is another question from the morning tours. What's the name of the bundle of fibers that bridges the two brain hemispheres? This was a question from the brain dissection tour from Joe. The answer was corpus callosum. We are getting towards the end of the first round. Which neurotransmitter deficit is observed in patients with Parkinson's disease? The answer is dopamine. Next question. What's the name of the round structure of the brain responsible for processing the sense of smell? The answer was olfactory bulb. Next question. What's the name of the amino acid transmitter in the brain whose primary function is to inhibit the firing of nerve cells? The answer was GABA. Wow. The last time we did the brain bee, the team GABA GABA did very good, I remember. Next question. The activity of neurons can change the way genes are expressed. This phenomenon is mediated by a specific class of proteins called activity-dependent. The answer was activity-dependent transcription factors. How are we doing? The next question is the last one for the first round. Now we are going to see you listen to me in the morning tours. What gene is deleted in this fly? The answer was the white gene. Because a wild type fly has red eyes, and when the gene is mutated, the flies have white eyes. And we named the gene from the phenotype of the mutation. This was the last question of the first round. So while the judges are counting the ballots, we can do the 3D printer raffle. So can we have someone from the Pew Foundation, if you want to come up here and pick the school that is going to win the 3D printer? Let me switch the microphone. So inside this box, there is one of your answer cards. And together with a 3D printer, there is also Matt, our IT specialist, coming to help you set it up and learn how to use it. So Marilena is mixing everything. Do you want to do something with the hands? Let's see who is winning. You go. Okay. The winner, you want to read it?
Oh, FAU team one.
Okay, so after today, I'm going to email your teacher to set up the 3D printer with your school. And this is going to all the three teams, okay? Okay, so while we are finishing to count the ballot, we can take 5 minutes if you need a break, stretch your legs, back here in 5 minutes, okay? Okay. While we wait for the ballots, we had a few teams asking about the answer for, you can read the question, Ananta.
Yes.
So the right answer was calcium, but a lot of you put sodium. So he's going to explain.
The question was, the arrival of an action potential at an axonal bouton opens channel that let which ion in? And there were some doubts between sodium and calcium. So the sodium and potassium ions, or that ion channels, are responsible for the generation of action potentials. But once the action potentials are generated, they come down to the axonal bouton and let calcium ion in through the calcium channels, voltage-sensitive calcium channels, that then release, or through that, there is release of neurotransmitters, right? So it's the calcium ion that's the right answer, yeah.
You can add it.
The importance of calcium in the presynaptic one or led to two Nobel Prizes and one Príncipe de Asturias Prize, just for that, because the calcium has a different role during the presynaptic and the postsynaptic. So just for it. So you can go and share it with your family and friends, of course.
So you also got a free neuroscience class from our judges. If everyone is here, we are ready to announce the teams that pass to the next round. So the good news is that there are going to be 11 teams passing, because we had two with the same number of points. So I'm going to read them in random orders, not in the orders of who did better or worse, okay? So the first team to pass to the next round is team number 14, the DOPA Finds. The next team to pass to the next round is team number 13, FAU team 3. The next team to pass to the second round is team number 15, NeuroScots 2. Another team to pass to the next round, team number 12, Medulla Minors. Next team is team number 6, Wildcats. The next team is my favorite name. Sorry. We always have a discussion about the best team, so this is the team that I think is my favorite this year for the name. Team number 20, Coco Locos. Next team to pass is FAU team 1. Mm-hmm. I just have 4 other teams. Next up, team number 8, Cerebellum Bells. Last 3 teams. Team number 4, Team Patella. The next team to pass is team number 11, NeuroScots 1. So I have the last team here. Team number 9, FAU Team 2. Congratulations to all the teams that are passing to their second round. For the eliminated teams, please take your cell phone, your gifts. If you want to stay, you can celebrate, guys. You can watch the rest of the competition in the auditorium downstairs if you want. And we can have a group picture at the end if you want to stay. Thank you so much for participating, and I hope to see you at the next event. Okay, I'm going to read one more time your names also for the people that are watching the live stream. So the next, the teams that are staying for the second round are NeuroScots 1 and NeuroScots 2 from St. Andrew's School, FAU Team 1, FAU Team 2, and FAU Team 3, Coco Locos from Jupiter High School, Wildcats from Royal Palm Beach Community High School. Where are you? Cerebellum Bells, Benjamin School. Dopa Pines, Benjamin School. I like your attitude. Medulla Minors, Lake Worth Middle School. And Team Patella from American Heritage School of the Palm Beach Campus. Congratulations. Yes, you're on to page. Team. Oh, yes. Yes, so now we are starting again from zero. So don't be too happy about yourself because you made it in the first round. Now we are again going to zero, so your maximum point can be 10. Yes. Yes, yes. So the top three pass to the final round. As in this round, if we have more than three teams with the same amount of points, we can have more than three teams going to the final round. The last time we did Brain B, we had four teams going to the last round. Always question included about the morning thing. Yes. Brain buzz questions are going to be in the final round. Also, they just remind me, I forgot something. There is a survey in your table that I was supposed to ask to your fellow friends also to fill. So I'm going to email the survey to them, but if you can fill it maybe at the end of this round, it will be great because we always are looking for ways to improve. Okay? Don't do the survey now because now we are starting with the second round perfectly on time. I'm sorry, Katie, I made you print 60 surveys and then I forgot. Round two, 10 questions. We start from zero again. The best three teams qualify for the final round. Good luck. What's the name of the new class of migraine drugs that activate a subgroup of serotonin receptors? Time is up. The answer was triptans. Second question. What is the name of the EM technique that combines both sectioning and imaging of tissue within the microscope? The name of the microscope that you saw this morning is Serial Block Phase Scanning Electron Microscopy, or SBF-SEM. Third question. An increase in the number and efficiency of this receptor is the basic mechanism for LTP. What's the name of the receptor? LTP stands for long-term potentiation. The name of the receptor is AMPA. Next question. Question from the morning tours. I'm sorry. Why does the mechanical workshop color all the microscopy parts in black? Thank you. The answer is to avoid the reflecting light. Anything that says the same concept is okay. The judges are going to review the answer. This is a question from one of the episode podcasts. What's the name of the cells discovered by the Nobel Prize winner John O'Keefe? Up, the answer was place cells. Oh, next question. In humans with narcolepsy, a neuropeptide level is pathologically low. What's the name of this neuropeptide? The neuropeptide has two names, orexin or hypocretin, are both acceptable answers. The circadian timing system is regulated by a group of nerve cells that acts as a master clock. What's the name of the group of these master cells? The name was suprachiasmatic nucleus. Yes. Do we have a? Ready for the next question? What's the name of the area circled in blue? The name of this area, pineal body. Yes.
Judges?
Yes. pineal gland works too as an answer. Next question. Microscopy question. What is the diffraction limit of a conventional light microscope? The answer was 200. Someone got it right. Either 200 nanometers or about half the wavelength of visible light are both acceptable answers. Next question. What is a technique that uses light to activate neurons, like in the moonwalk flies? The name of the technique is optogenetics. Okay. This was the last question. So now give us a few minutes to count, and then the best three teams or the one with the same amount of points are going to pass to the next round, okay? While you wait, if you don't mind, filling up the survey. Thank you. So it seems like a lot of teams are going to make it to the next round. Okay. I take back what I said. The last question really changed everything. So I'm going to announce the three teams that are going to pass to the final round. The first team to pass to the final round is team number 6, Wildcats. Good job. The second team to pass to the final round is FAU team 2. I have the last team. Why are you saying no way? Did you cheat or something? Last team to pass to the final round of the 2022 Brain B is team 11, Neuroscots 1. Congratulations. So for all the other teams, please note that apart from the first three, all the others, you were all tied. So you all did great. Please fill the survey and leave it on the table if you didn't do it already. And you can stick around and stay downstairs. I don't know. And if you want to wait for the end of the competition and watch from the auditorium, then you can celebrate the winners. So I will ask. Yes, so we are going to take a couple of minutes break. And we are going to move the three remaining teams in front. So we have you guys here. The worst. So. The three teams, you're going to win a trophy for sure. You are going to have a gift card, and the winner team is also going to win a day here at Max Planck. And so now we are going on the direct elimination again. We have FAU team 2 from FAU High. We have team 11, Neuroscots 1 from Sam Andrew School, and then we have team Wildcats from Royal Palm Beach Community High School. So please, if you can move in front, so we are all here, and please, runners, if you can pick one table each. So now you're going to have a concierge service to picking up your answer. The people can see you. Before starting the next round, I want to remind you that in this round there are going to be brain buzz questions. For those questions, you just have to have an answer card and just write your answer without talking to your friends. And since we are at the last round, I want to make sure I can pronounce your name because I'm going to pronounce the name of the winners very soon. So again, we have Team NeuroScots 1 from St. Andrew School, Ava Allward, Nikita Pavlenko, and Lara Lemke. Congratulations. Then we have FAU Team 2 from FAU High School, Vidat Muta, Kyle Sagan, and Aryun Doshi. And last but not least, Team Wildcats from Royal Palm Beach Community High School. We have Jonathan Holt, Malachi Maldonado, and Andrew Chamberlain. Congratulations on making it to the final round. And I think that now we are ready to start to the last round, direct elimination. Do you have any questions? So the way it's going to work, we are going to go slow here, because if all of you get it wrong, we keep going. If all of you get it right, we keep going. If two get it wrong, one right, we have a winner, but we have to keep going for the second and the third, and so on. So for the brain buzz question, each correct answer counts as one. So you can get 3, 2, 1, or 0. And we are going to count who did best on that. No, you don't get it eliminated if one gets it wrong, but if another team, all the three members get it right, then they are going to win. Okay, good luck. First question. Why is the chamber of an electron microscope generally kept under vacuum? Okay, and I'm not going, so just one answer per, wait, just one answer per team, okay? I'm going to tell you when it's time to all of you give me the answer. So before giving the answer, I'm going. All of three of you got it right. Gas molecule cause the electron beam to scatter. Good job. Okay. Brain buzz question. So please, if you can stand in front of your table and be ready to just get the answer. So each of you, you have to write your answer to this question in your piece of paper. Do not talk to the others and just give it to our volunteers, okay? Name both ions involved in the action potential. Both, so two. Thank you. I have the feeling we are going to stay here up to tomorrow. Okay, the answer was sodium and potassium. We are going to keep going, okay? We don't have a winner yet. We don't have a winner, so we are going to keep going, okay? The next, so and for the next question, it is a normal question. You can chat for the next one. Okay, for this question, we just need one answer for each team. Ready? What's the name of the enlargement on the axon tip that actively explore the environment to find their precise destination? Okay, this was a question both in your book and also Nikolai during the STED tour mentioned it. And you keep going, right? No, did I move on? Let me see. We have a winner. We have a winner. Okay, I'm not. We have a winner.
We have a winner.
Yes. Okay. So I'm not going to say the answer, otherwise the winning team will know that they won. I think we can, for everyone that is in the auditorium, we can open the door. Everyone can come upstairs. And then we are going to announce the first, the second, and the third, okay? So, during the brain bus question, one we found the third team because two teams did perfect. And then we keep going for the first and the second, and just one team got the correct answer. And so now we know who is the first and the other one is the second. Okay? So, okay, your friends are coming up, your teacher is coming up. Yes. Okay, please come in. You can enter and come closer. Okay. I'm going to start with the third place. And when I call you, then you can go there and you're going to receive your trophy, your monetary prize. So get ready. So the team that takes home the third place in the 2022 Brainbee is FAU Team 2. Didant Mutta, Kyle Sagon, and Aryun Doshi. Congratulations. So you get a trophy and a $50 Amazon gift card. Congratulations. And I forgot, for all the participants, I'm going to email your participation certificate next week. Okay, so now I should say the first, right? And then the second. Okay, so I'm going to announce the winner. The winner of the 2022 Brainbee is Team Wildcats from Royal Palm Beach Community High School. And the second team is NeuroScots 1 from St. Andrew School. Congratulations, Ava Allward, Nikita Pavlenko, and Lara Lemke. Good job. For the students that are back here, if you didn't fill your feedback survey and you still have time, there are some feedback surveys on the table and I will really appreciate your feedback so we can make the brain be even better next year. Thank you so much. So when we are ready, we have some confetti cannons.
Wow. I didn't even get anything. Woo!
Congratulations. So the second team wins a $100 gift card. The first team wins a $150 gift card. And check your email because I'm going to set up a day at Max Planck for you guys.
I just forgot one thing.
So after we are done with the picture, we are going to take a group picture downstairs. Before we close, I